लेट मी अलाउ स्टूडेंट्स दैट दे कैन ज्वाइन। बेटा विच ग्रुप इज प्रेजेंट, ताकि हम इनकी प्रेजेंटेशन आप लोगों में ले लें। अल्फिया इज योर ग्रुप प्रेजेंट? Yes, beta, you have to raise your hand that I can unmute you. So they haven't joined. Okay, ask them to join as soon as possible. Aman, are you there? Unmute yourself. Yes, Aman.
Yes, sir.
How are you?
Sir, I'm fine. How are you?
I'm fine. How is going your paper? How the preparation is going on?
My preparation is almost done, completed.
Okay, that's good. And what about the paper
sir, repeating...
sociology?
Sociology, sir, I will be preparing myself for sociology by tomorrow.
Okay, by tomorrow. Okay. Okay, brother. Wish you best of luck.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yes, who was the next group? Apart from Alfia, I think there was someone else. Who was she? Maria. Yes, Maria. Are your members present? Maria, but if your members are present, then you should start first. No, sir. Then, beta, ask them to join and give your presentation, because we have joined again only because of you two, your group and the group of Alfia. Okay, Bushra. Yes, beta, unmute yourself.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Walaikum assalam.
Sir, my presentation aaj thi, lekin mera net issue ki wajah se jo hai mera group ki presentation ho gayi aur meri reh gayi. मेरा टॉपिक इंग्लिश लिटरेचर था। आप बता दें आप कब होगी मेरी प्रेजेंटेशन?
बेटा अभी आप दे दें अगर आप देना चाह रही हैं तो।
यस मैं देना चाह रही हूँ।
ओके दे दें आप। माय आफ्टर बुशरा।
यस सर।
Yes, beta, start.
Everyone here can hear me?
Yes, go ahead.
History of English literature. Duke of Norman named William Change Harold King of Anglo-Saxon. William defeated Harold. William became the King of England. Language of the country was the language of the ruler. French became the language of court, parliament, and elite society for three centuries around 1336. Common people did not change their language. Norman, Anglo-Saxon, Norman, Anglo-Norman in between language called Middle Language. English became the language of court, East Midland dialect, 1400 to 1485 Baron period. 166 to 1340 Anglo-Norman period. Havelock by Dan, Lofron by Thomas of Hesse, The Owl and the Nightingale. 1362, English become the language of court, Black Death, 1348 to 49, of population death. 100 Years War, England, France, Edward III region, it was considered as glorious period. Regard two region, it was called troublesome period. Peasant revolt in 1381, which is also called Ruler's Rebellion. Decline of feudalism, growing power of labor class, age of Chaucer. Pearl Poet or Gavin Poet. Pearl, Patience, Clearance, Sir Gawain, and the Green Knight. Five poets of Chaucer's and contemporaries. Father of English literature, father of English poetry, earliest of great moderns, the morning star of Renaissance. Number two, Langland, Johann Weissen, the morning star of Reformation, Johann Joser, Mendeleev, morning star of Indian Renaissance, Christopher Marlowe, the true child of Renaissance. Yes, sir, I completed.
Okay, it was very brief. And please say the word Anglo-Saxon. Yes, Peter Bushra. Jaldi mein mute kar diya. Okay, go ahead. Students are inviting. Yes, two students are inviting. Unko maine allow kar diya beta. Yes, which group is ready now, beta? Where's your hand? Maria. Okay, Maria, beta. Unmute yourself.
सर हफ्सा एंड दुआ वो दोनों मेरे ग्रुप में स्टार्ट हफ्सा करेगी.
अच्छा उनको बोलें कि वो बस अपना हैंड रेज कर दें ताकि मैं उनको अनम्यूट करें और उनका नेम टॉप पे आ जाएगा. अच्छा सी बेटा आसिया जी आर यू हैव टू राइट द नेम ऑफ बुशरा कि उनका ताल्लुक किस ग्रुप से था चूंकि उन्होंने अपने ग्रुप के साथ प्रेजेंटेशन नहीं दी थी तो यू हैव टू राइट हर नेम एंड देन लेट मी नो. जब मैं आपसे पूछूंगा ये जो लोग मिसिंग हो रहे हैं या बाद में दे रहे हैं तो इनका रिकॉर्ड अपने पास आप रखिएगा और मैं आपसे पूछूंगा. ठीक है बेटा इस बात को याद रखिएगा. ओके ओके दुआ इज गोइंग टू स्टार्ट बेटा. ओके दुआ यस यस बेटा अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ एंड से दैट टेल मी दैट हु इज गोइंग टू स्टार्ट.
सर हफ्सा स्टार्ट करेगी.
तो हफ्सा इज नॉट रेजिंग हर हैंड बेटा. इज शी प्रेजेंट हफ्सा अब्दुल मजीद. ओके लेट मी फाइंड हर हफ्सा. ओके हफ्सा यस बेटा अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ हफ्सा.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम सर.
वालेकुम अस्सलाम बेटा.
इन द नेम ऑफ अल्लाह हु इज द मोस्ट बेनिफिशिएंट एंड द मोस्ट मर्सीफुल आई होप दैट यू ऑल आर फाइन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई थैंकफुल फॉर माय रिस्पेक्टेड टीचर हु गेव मी अ चांस. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द नॉर्मन एज.
बेटा आप लोगों ने मुझे पीपीटी सेंड की थी क्या?
यस सर.
पीपीटी आप लोगों ने मुझे सेंड की थी ग्रुप में?
यस यस सर।
ओके ओके, वेट वेट, तो मैं आपकी स्लाइड को शेयर करता हूँ ना, उसके बाद आप वेट, लेट मी फाइंड इट फॉर यू। व्हाट इज टॉपिक?
एंग्लो नॉर्मन पीरियड।
एंग्लो नॉर्मन पीरियड, प्रोग्रेसिव स्पीच। कल आप लोगों ने शेयर की थी पीपीटी बेटा?
यस सर।
लेट मी फाइंड इट।
नो सर, आज की है सर।
आज की है, ओके। एंग्लो नॉर्मन एज। मिडिल इंग्लिश, फिगर ऑफ स्पीच, फिगर ऑफ स्पीच, मिडिल इंग्लिश। अमान ने प्रेजेंटेशन शेयर की हुई है एक, बेटा ग्रुप में तो नहीं है आपकी पीपीटी। एंग्लो नॉर्मन एज आप लोगों ने ग्रुप में शेयर की है? बेटा आप लोगों ने ग्रुप में शेयर की थी? लेट मी नो। मारिया बेटा अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ, आप बताएं। आई डोंट नो, आई थिंक अफसान नो नथिंग। सर जी आर ने सेंड किया है आपको, ओके। डायरेक्ट अगर मुझे, मैं ग्रुप में ढूंढ रहा हूँ बेटा, मुझे अब क्या पता कि कहाँ पर। लेट मी चेक कि मुझे डायरेक्ट आया हुआ है।
नंबर 14 है हमारा
ग्रुप नंबर 14।
यस सर।
ओके 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 ओके, ठीक है, मिल गई मैं ग्रुप में पड़ी हुई। लेट मी शेयर, दिस इज योर पीपीटी मारिया। ओके आप सर, ठीक है बेटा, आई यू मे स्टार्ट।
द एंग्लो नॉर्मन पीरियड वर स्टार्टेड 1066 टू 1500। द नॉर्मन पीपल्स बिलोंग्स टू फ्रांस इन द लीडरशिप ऑफ विलियम द कॉन्करर देयर किंग। दे अटैक on England. The Battle of Hastings 1066 was fought between Normans and Anglo-Saxons. In the battle, Normans got victory. Then William became the master king of England. The Norman King William the Conqueror defeated the Anglo-Saxon King Harold at the Battle of Hastings 1066 and conquered England. Norman conquest brought enormous changes in England, English literature and linguistics. Norman conquest. When in 1066, Edward the Confessor died childless, England was again faced with the choice of successor. Edward had divided England into a few large districts, each under the control of a powerful earl. The most influential of these nobles were Godwin, Earl of the West Saxon Earldom. The day after Edward's death, Harold, the son of Godwin, was elected king. William, the Duke of Normandy at this time, was the second cousin of late King Edward. When Harold did not consider well William's order, only by force could William hope to obtain the crown. First, William landed on the south coast of England with a formidable force. His landing was unopposed. Harold was occupied in the north of England meeting an invasion by the King of Norway, another claimant to their throne. Harold hardly triumphed in battle. Harold reached at a point between the Norman host and London. He drew up his forces on a broad hill at Senlac, not far from Hastings, and awaited William's attack. Battle began early in the morning, and Englishmen fought bravely till afternoon, and their Normans attack very dangerously. Harold, also a part of the fight, was killed during the battle. According to tradition, he was pierced in the eyes by the Norman arrow. Two of Harold's brothers had already killed. William had won the Battle of Hastings and eliminated his rival. On Christmas Day, 1066, William was crowned King of England. Change in England after Norman conquest. The Norman Conquest brought changes in the literature as well as political history of England. The Anglo-Saxon other word then as suddenly and permanently displaced. Many of the English higher class had been killed on the field of Hastings. Those who escaped were treated as treasure. Norman introduced a foreign type of literature in England. French language was used in churches and monasteries. English language was thrown in background. Thank you, sir.
I was typing the message, but your presentation is done. So, Fiza Memon, you have just drawn the line on the PPT, so don't do this again. Next presenter is Dua or Maria. Who's next presenter, beta? Yes, Dua. Are you the next presenter?
No, sir. Maria ki.
Okay. That's... Yes, Maria, beta, unmute yourself.
Assalamu alaikum. This is Maria Umar. Today, my topic is about Anglo-Norman. Changes in English literature. After Norman conquest, the literature read and written by Englishmen was completely transformed as the sentiments and tastes of English rules. Normans imported scholars to revive knowledge, chronicles to record memorable events. This period is also marked by disappearance of old English poetry. The religious poetry was also disappeared after Norman conquest. Changes in English language. The Middle English period was marked by momentous changes in the English language, changes more extensive and fundamental than those that have taken place at any time before or since. English language having been thrown into the background, English was used by lower class. Following are some changes in English grammar. Decay of inflectional endings, strong verbs became weak, loss of grammatical gender. French influences is much more direct and observable upon the vocabulary. Thousands of French words introduced into English. In changing from French to English, they transformed much of their governmental and administrative vocabulary of art, learning, and medicine. Like government, tax, crown, religion, proof, prison, bell, judge, navy, fashion, dress, frog, blue, rose, fry, etc. Literature of Anglo-Norman period. It was most popular form of literature. These are notable for their stories other than their poetry Canterbury Tales. These romances were borrowed from Latin and French. They deal with the stories of King Arthur, the War of Troy, and of Alexander the Great. No literary production of the Middle English are so characteristic or of high value. The miracle plays. These plays became very popular from the growth and development of the Bible story, since by scene carried to its logical conclusion. This drama developed to a cycle of sacred history, beginning with the creation of man, his fall and banishment from Garden of Eden, and matters of Old Testament and life of Christ. This kind of drama is called miracle plays, morality plays. In this form of drama, uniform themes is the struggle between the powers of good and evil. The personages, famous people, were abstract, virtuous or vices, each acting and speaking in accordance with his name, and the plot was built upon the correct contracts and influences on human nature. Now I invite Dua.
unmute yourself, beta.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I start with the name of Allah, who is the most merciful. Assalamu alaikum to everyone. My name is Dua Batul. Today I am telling you about famous poets of English. Geoffrey Chaucer, he was the real founder of English poetry, called the father of English poetry. Chaucer made a fresh beginning in English literature. He disregarded the old English tradition. Chaucer poetry has been read and enjoyed from this first day to today. His work, famous work of Chaucer, is the Canterbury Tales, which collection of two stories related by pilgrims on Canterbury. This is in the history of English poetry. These pilgrims represented different sections of English society. His work fall into three periods. First period, he started French poets and long poem Le Roman de la Rose, of which he made a translation romantic of the rose. During this period, he also wrote the book of the Duchess, which end from a nature like romance of the rose, complained into pity, a shorter poem. Second period, in this period, he was inspired by Italian writers. In this period, he wrote the Parliament of Flows, which contain very dramatic and satiric dialogues. Third period, this period called English period. In this period, he wrote Legend of God, a Good Woman, the Caribelli Tres, his greatest achievement, William Langland. He was one of the greatest poet in the Middle Age. His poem, a Vision of Prize of It is a classical work and satiric in the current religions. He represented lower class in the poetry. Thank you so much.
Okay, beta. Okay. Let me give you some comments over your presentation. The first presenter was Hafsa. Hafsa, it was a good introduction, and the common thing which I found in all three members, that I found that you all were reading the slides, the material which was written on the slide, you were reading it word by word. So it was quite a negative point which I found in your presentation. Overall, the impression of your presentation is quite average. It's not too good, it's not too bad, it's just average. And especially, let me say something to Dua Batul. Dua, you still better need to do a lot of hard work to improve yourself, because the way you were pronouncing the words, it was, you see, अगर जेफरी चौसर को ना ये उन्होंने सुना होगा तो उसकी रूह भी तड़प रही होगी कि आपने कैंटरबरी टेल्स को किस तरह से प्रोनाउंस किया है. सो यू इवन डिड नो हाउ टू प्रोनाउंस द फ्रेंच Parliament, satire, these are the words you need to pronounce in them. Even parliament is a very common word, beta. Wo hum rozana news mein idhar udhar sunte rehte hain. So see, it's a word like parliament. And the second was satire, French. So the most negative thing which I found, that you even don't know how to pronounce the word Canterbury Tales. Lekin beta, kabhi kabhi hum English speaker to nahi hai, native speakers to hum mein se koi bhi nahi hai. तो इंग्लिश इज अ सेकंड लैंग्वेज या थर्ड लैंग्वेज, तो अब जब हमारे पास इंग्लिश एज अ सेकंड लैंग्वेज एंड थर्ड लैंग्वेज आ रही है, तो यू सी वेन एवर यू आर having or you are seeing some difficult words, all you need to do is go and write down that word in the Google and listen the translation or listen the pronunciation. Even you might have the dictionaries as well. Agar kisi ke paas Oxford Purchase Dictionary mobile mein hai to wo wahan se usko bhi sun sakta hai. Even ek aur bhi dictionary hai jo mere mobile mein bhi installed hai, but क्या नाम है उसका अभी मेरे ध्यान में नहीं आ रहा, बिकॉज मोबाइल इज क्वाइट अवे फ्रॉम मी, सो दैट्स आई एम अनएबल टू अप्रोच इट. तो सी बेटा, आप मोबाइल में ऐसी डिक्शनरीज लगा सकते हैं जिसमें आप वर्ड टाइप करेंगे एंड देन यू कैन लिसन द प्रोनाउंसिएशन एंड यू कैन हैव द मीनिंग एज वेल. अगर आपके पास ये अपॉर्चुनिटी भी नहीं है तो कम से कम आप गूगल पे भी सर्च सकते हैं. इट इज योर प्रेजेंटेशन, सो इफ यू सी दैट देयर आर सम डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स देन यू मस्ट write them on Google and then listen the pronunciation. जब आप उनकी pronunciation एक मतलब सुनेंगे या दो मतलब सुनेंगे तो you will know how to pronounce such difficult words. So you see, you have to take care, you have to take very great care about these things in your next presentation or in future. I hope ke this feedback will help you to improve yourself. See beta, Dua, I'm not here to discourage you. I'm not going to discourage you. Neither I will ever try to discourage you or anyone else. But the point is कि अगर मैं आपको बताऊंगा नहीं तो आप इम्प्रूवमेंट कैसे करेंगे बेटा, आपको कैसे पता लगेगा कि आपने क्या क्या मिस्टेक्स किए हैं या ब्लंडर्स किए हैं. सो आई एम हेयर टू नोटिस द मिस्टेक्स एंड टेल यू टू इम्प्रूव दैम. नाउ इट इज अप टू यू दैट वेदर यू आर गोइंग टू इम्प्रूव दैम और नॉट. सो विश यू वेरी बेस्ट ऑफ लक. नाउ लेट्स मूव फॉरवर्ड टू द नेक्स्ट ग्रुप. यस अल्फिया बेटा, यू हैव टू रेज योर हैंड. ओके, यस.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम सर.
वालेकुम अस्सलाम. यस बेटा,
आयशा इज नॉट प्रेजेंट हियर राइट नाउ. इट्स जस्ट ओनली मी एंड हरीबा हु विल गिव द प्रेजेंटेशन.
डिड यू सेंड मी द पीपीटी?
यस सर, आई हैव सेंट यू द पीपीटी.
व्हाट इज द टॉपिक नेम, नेम ऑफ योर टॉपिक बेटा? टॉपिक नेम बताओ.
इट वाज मिडिल इंग्लिश.
It was a middle English. Okay, let me check it for you. Middle English. Okay. Yes, Alfia and Ariba and Aisha. Okay. Sivita, who's going to start now?
Sir, Ariba will start.
Ariba, you have to raise your hand that your name would come can come on the top of the list, Vita. Ariba Abbasi?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Ariba Abbasi, unmute yourself.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, beta, I can hear you.
Assalamu alaikum, respected sir and fellow classmates. I am Ariba Abbasi, and today I am going to present the topic Middle English. Middle English is the name given by historical linguistic to the device from the English language spoken between the Norman invasion of 166 AD and about 147 AD. Then the Chancery Standard, a form of London-based English, began to become widespread, a process added by the introduction of the printing press into England by William Caxton in the 1470. Characteristic of this age, peasant revolt in the held in 1381, people refuse them, so is in anger they increase the taxes, but people for justice tried to kill their lords. The lord used to rule on people and impose taxes on them. Tyler was the leader of revolt and it ended when he died. Alternative poetry, it mean unrhymed poetry. The founder of this technique was William Langland. The poetry of this age was traditional because he composed his literature from past as his subject matters, but not from his society. The founder of this technique was William Langland. One of his significant work is Piers Plowman. Now, Alfia Shabir discuss court language.
Sir, can you hear me? Okay, sir. So, respected teacher and my fellow classmates, assalamu alaikum. And now I'm going to continue the from where the Ariba has left. So the third characteristic of this age was court languages. So the court languages are those languages which are used in royal courts by kings. So in that age, French and Latin were the court languages, which means that the rules, the laws, every activity which was done in the court was done by these languages. But when Mr. Chaucer started writing in English, so it got much popular, and then the English was also considered as court language. Now, who was Geoffrey Chaucer? So the Mr. Geoffrey Chaucer was the father and the founder of English. He was the one who has made a big impact in this Middle Age. Now he has done some of the very. Now we are just going to talk about his education. So his education was divided into three parts. The first part was the Italian literature, and it was inspired by Dante's writing. He was inspired by Dante's writing. That's why he has learned Italian literature. Number two, he had his education in French and Latin literature, which was his basic education. Number three, from his personal experiences of life. Now how? Because he loves to wander. So the kings used to allow him to go to other places of the lands, and he used to travel, and from there he used to gain experiences. Now talking about the kings, so he has worked under three kings as he was a political man. Number one was King Edward III, number two, King Richard II, and number three, King Henry IV. His famous work was Canterbury Tales. He was known for this. It was a poetry. And because of this today, the English language is surviving. Now, there are 24 tales in this book. Originally, he wanted to write 120 tales, but because he died, so there are only 24 tales in this book, and the book left incompleted. And there are 29 characters in this poetry. Thank you, sir. I guess it's...
Okay. Is there anyone left?
Yes, there is another one. Okay. So the characters which he has shown in his book were student, cook, shipman, priest, clerk. It means that they were very common people. Student, husband, wife, a family. He has shown these types of people in their book, in his book. He wanted to give the... Originally, he wrote this book because he wanted to give the concept of right and wrong, and he wanted to show that how is the society and what is the real picture of society by his imagination. And because of this, his age is also known as Age of Chaucer. Thank you.
Okay, Beta. Anyone is remaining from your group, Beta?
Yes, sir. Aisha is remaining, but because of some issues,
she's absent. Okay. That's good. We are also running out of time. We have just 6 minutes left in this session. Khan Mohammad, I'm very sorry, Beta. Okay, unmute yourself, Khan Mohammad.
Sir, Assalamu alaikum.
Walaikum assalam. Beta, aap akele hain, individually denge ya group ke saath hain?
Group ke saath hain, sir.
Kitne members hain aapke group mein?
Ji, total 4 hain.
Sab present hain abhi?
Ji, sir.
ये तीसरा जो हमारा सेशन है, इसके खत्म होने में जस्ट 6 मिनट्स आर माइनिंग. तो हम इन 6 मिनट्स में तो आपकी प्रेजेंटेशन नहीं ले सकते हैं. तो आज 3 सेशन हमने लगातार लिए हैं, तो अब चौथा भी लेंगे तो फिर स्टूडेंट्स फिर दिल में पता नहीं कितनी बद्दुआएं देंगे, वो मुझे पता है. सो लेट्स टेक योर प्रेजेंटेशन टुमारो. ओके
ओके सर थैंक यू.
ओके सो लेट मी गिव यू फीडबैक ओवर द लास्ट प्रेजेंटेशन. अरीबा अब्बासी, योर इंट्रोडक्शन वॉज क्वाइट गुड, एंड द वे यू वर गिविंग योर प्रेजेंटेशन दैट वॉज ऑल्सो वेरी मच एक्सीलेंट, एंड आई लाइक दैट वे. एंड आई लाइक ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स हु शुड गिव देयर प्रेजेंटेशन थ्रू दैट वे, लाइक महनूर वॉज देयर, अरीबा अब्बासी इज देयर, and Maryam was there. Especially the Maryam's presentation was excellent, and it was an ideal one. So you see, you should use such kind of way to give presentation through online mode that everything should be easy to be understood. But there were some pronunciation issues in your presentation, Ariba, like it's not pupil, it's people, and it's not significant, it's significant. So these, you also made some other mistakes in the pronunciation. So I couldn't make note them down, all of them. So these are the few which I noticed. Overall, your presentation was very much good. Now let's come to the Alfia. Alfia, it was one of the best presentation as well. And it was very much impressive because especially in terms of content. Beta, jab aap log presentation dete hain, to उसमें जो सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट चीज़ जो मैं नोटिस करता हूँ, जो कंटेंट आप बता रहे हैं तो वो बड़ा मैटर करता है. और सिर्फ वो बताना नहीं होता है, उसका एक सीक्वेंस भी होता है कि आप जिस सीक्वेंस में आप उसको बता रहे हैं और जिस राइमिंग में जहाँ जिस वे में आप उसको एक्सप्लेन कर रहे हैं, दैट मस्ट बी अप टू द मार्क. अगर वो आपका अच्छा होता है तो ओवरऑल आपकी प्रेजेंटेशन का जो इमेज होता है दैट बिकम्स वेरी मच हायर. So same thing goes to Alfia as well, ke the way you were delivering your content, and the content was excellent. So that's why the way you were delivering it, that was also excellent. So that's why I have just felt that your presentation is also one of the best presentation which are given through online mode. So it was all about this presentation. So still some students are remaining, and I hope tomorrow I'll be done with the presentations of your class. And if you have any queries or if you wanted to ask anything, then tomorrow you will have chance to ask me questions, your queries regarding your paper or anything else you want to discuss, I want to ask. So this is end for now. So see you tomorrow. Allah Hafiz. Okay, beta, I'm going to end this meeting for all. Mm-hmm.